Hi guys, and welcome to another amazing music theory video clip. And this week's homework will include pages 37, 38, and 39. We'll be talking about scale degree numbers and melodies, helpful hints for writing scale degrees and scales and stuff, which is basically a revision page. So let's get straight to it. Okay guys, so let's start with page 37, scale degree numbers in melodies. So let's, at this stage, remind ourselves that our scale degrees come from the major scales we've learned already in this grade. Let's just revise here how we work out our scale degrees. Here is our G major scale. The first note of the scale will always be called number one. The last note of the scale then will also be called number one. When we're working out scale degrees in melodies, however, all G's will be called number one, no matter where they are on the stave. So we work up our scale degrees, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. And because we're about to work out melody scale degrees, we must call this top G also number one. Writing scale degrees under a melody is just like writing them under a scale, except that the notes are out of order. A tune can start on any scale degree of the scale. Write in the missing scale degrees for this famous tune in G major. Let me play it to you. I'm sure some of you may have played that on your instruments already. It's a famous Baroque minuet. We can go ahead and at least start by putting the number one in on all of the G's in this piece. And from there, you can work out all of the other notes. 1, 2, 3, 4, etc. So go ahead and have a shot at filling in the rest of those scale degrees. Second question, finish writing the scale degree numbers under these melodies. Use numbers only 1 to 7. The first thing to do is work out which scale each of these melodies is written in, the key signature, and secondly, the last note of the tune. It must be F major. All Fs in this tune must be number one. From there, work out the other scale degree. We'll help you out here. From F goes up to G, one position, so then must be scale degree 2. See if you can work out the rest. The next question, let's work out what key it's written in. The clues are the key signature and the final note. Here we have the key signature of nothing, no flats, no sharps, and our final note in the bass clef is C. It must be C major. Go ahead and write in all of your number ones on all of the C's in the melody. 1, 1, 1, and 1. From there you can work out all the other numbers. So one position before number one will be number 7 in our scale degrees. See if you can work out the others. In the melodies below, work out which note is number 1. Then fill in the scale degree numbers. To do this, you must work out the key first, and then double check the clef. Looking at the key signature, looking at the clef, looking at the final note, this will help you work out the key. Here in the treble clef, we finish on an F. So that tells you the tonic of this key, F. It must be F major. See if you can work out the key of the next one then. Looking at the clef, the key signature, which is an F sharp, and the final note. And then you can go ahead and fill in your number ones. So the number one will be here in the F major melody, and number one will be here as well in this melody. So see if you can now fill in the rest of the scale degrees and work out which key is this melody written in. Okay, so now on to page 38, helpful hints for scale degrees. Here they are. If the notes go up in the melody, then count forward, 1, 2, 3, 4, etc. If the notes go down in the melody, count backwards. So from 1, we go backwards to 7, then 6, 5, 4, etc. Do not assume the melody will start on the scale degree 1. It often doesn't. But melodies usually do end on scale degree 1. Beware of ending on a different number. You might have misread the key or the clef. I'm going to help you out here with the first melody, and then you go ahead and work out the other three by yourself. Firstly, check your clef. Then look at your key signature. Look at the final note here. This will usually tell you, number 1, the tonic of the scale. In the treble clef, this note is number 1 in G major. Find all the G's and mark in all my number ones. We go back here and we have a G here, an octave below, so we can mark in a number one there. We also have a G here, an octave below, so we can go and mark our number one there. So with our number ones marked in, we can work out all our other numbers. Let's help you out here. So from this G, we can work backwards and work out this note here. From G, we go up to A, which will be 2. Going up one more position to B, then will be number 3. From this point, number 1, we can then work out the next note here. From G goes up to A, number 2, up to B, number 3, up to C, then number 4. From number 4, we can work backwards back down again to B, number 3, and A then will be number 2. Now, we've got to go below number 1 here, so remember, when the melody goes down, we must work backwards. Before number 1, always then will come 7th scale degree. Go ahead and see if you can work out the next 3, and then the next 3 melodies on the rest of our page. And so finally, page 39, scales and stuff, which is basically a revision page. And I'll go through a little bit of each question here and leave you to complete the rest. Circle the correct F major key signature. You can flip back in your through your pages to find the scale F major and make sure you check really carefully where each accidental needs to be in both of the clefs. Also making sure the accidentals are written in the right way, pointing in the right direction. Write the scale degree numbers under the notes of this melody. Using the same method that we used on the previous page, take note of your clef, our key signature, which in this case has no flats and no sharps, and then our final note of the melody, which will tell you the first scale degree in the bass clef. This note here is a C. And so this will be our number 1. So then go through the whole melody and find all the C's. Here's another, will also be number 1. Here's another up the octave, which will also be number 1. Here's another, which will also be number 1. See if you can finish the rest of these scale degrees. Question 3. In the melody above, mark all of these semitones with a slur. This is a tricky question. You could either look for these combinations of numbers next to each other. 3 and 4 together, 4 and 3 together, 7 and 1 together, or 1 and 7 together. You could also look back to the picture of the keyboard here on page 14. This will also remind you how to work out tones and semitones. Question 4, what is the other name for a semibrieve rest? Write these notes as dotted minims using ledger lines. So let me help you out here with the first one. We have 2 tasks here, to write dotted minims, and secondly, to use ledger lines. So here in treble clef, we must find a B flat using ledger lines. We can have 2 options. We can either go down here below the stave, or we could go up here above the stave, and either would be correct. Then to make our dotted minims, we need a stem to make either a puppy or a dog. And then to make a dotted minim, we need to add the dot to the right hand side of the note. Remember, when you're drawing a dotted minim on a line, the dot must go above the line so that we can see clearly the dot. Okay, good luck, boys.